So let's start out with what we know first. We know what we want to test. So I'll go into the plot tester, and I'll create a new plot of the size that we did the example for. And then I'll print out the actual, which should be the number of fields if the radius is 400. And then I'll print out the expected number that we calculated, which was 8. Now to actually do the calculation, first thing I do is calculate the number of rows, which should be an int. And the way that we did that was to calculate the length minus the diameter divided by the radius times the square root of 3. But that wasn't counting the first row, so I've got to add the first row back. And since there are some doubles in here, I won't automatically get integer division. So to drop the fractional part, I'll need to actually cast this. Now I haven't actually defined diameter, but that's just twice the radius. After that, I calculated the number of odd rows, which was the total number of rows plus 1 divided by 2. And the number of even rows was just n rows over 2. The number of columns in each odd row was based on the width and the diameter. I want to make sure that I actually get an int here. So I noticed that the width is an int and the diameter is also an int. So that's good. The columns in an even row was the width, but we couldn't use that first space at the left. So we have to subtract off 1 radius before we divide to see how many diameters fit across. And then the total number of fields is the odd rows times the number of columns per odd row, and then the number of even rows times the number of columns per even row. And this number, total fields, is what we wanted to return. Let's find all my typos. Huh, got lucky that time. Let's see if the plot tester agrees. Looks like it at least worked for the example that we checked. That's a good sign. That was a pretty tricky problem. If you struggled, way to stick with it.